Hey guys, YankeeGamer5 here, we're back for more Let's Play Paper Mario. So right now, we're up to the Peach Interlude, with Bowser's epic music. I'll look at him go in there, like, all seductive-like, that sly dog. Let's see what brilliant ideas he has to say this time. Ha! Hello, how are you feeling, princess? Nothing makes me happier than a smile from you, Peach.
Well, tough luck. I'm in a very bad mood, you monster. You've imprisoned all of the guests from the castle. You are the single greatest disaster ever befall the Mushroom Kingdom. I'll tell you what. I'll smile when you make everything as if it was before you showed up.
Ho, that's rich. You know I can't do that. That jerk Mario has just defeated Koopa Bros and Tun Koopa. Sure, they were complete wimps, but they were still loyal to me. I can't forgive Mario for disrespecting me. I'm ripping this right in the bud. Now I'm gonna stick the Invincible Tubba Blubba on him. He's the strongest creature I know. Well, after me. You best forget about Mario.
Your nastiness! We have a problem!
Why, Kami Koopa, what's all this got all riled up? You look upset. What?! The Star Spirit flew away from Tubba Blubba's castle!
King Bowser, keep your voice down. Princess Peach will hear you.
I guess you're right. Tell me the details over there. In the room right next to hers. So she still can't listen to us. For 5 feet away. And it just slams.
Twink, did you hear that?
Yeah, I sure did. The Star Spirit must have escaped. Did you hear him call that Tubba Blubba thing invincible?
That doesn't sound good. Do you think Mario can win?
Well, we better try to find out about Tubba Blubba. If you can find something, anything about a weak point, it might just save Mario.
Good idea!
Then there's no time to lose. We won't get anything done if we stay in this room.
Onward to the secret switch. Cha-ching! Press! I totally whiffed on that, but whatever. Let's go through the fireplace. Into the fire and flames. We still gotta do this. After this chapter, they just do it for you. But I guess they have to make you do this again, so push the button again. Whee! It's like Scooby-Doo, the revolving bookcase. And we're back in Bowser's diary room, or study, I don't know what it is. Yeah, his diary's gone, obviously. He probably moved it. There's still guards outside, be careful not to get caught. Alright, this is how we have to get stealth. Metal Peach. Come on, get past those guards. If you get caught in the light, you have to go back to your room. So don't get caught. So in this little interlude, these guards are here too. Probably lots of them. We better be extra careful. Well, in this Peach interlude, you gotta be very careful not to get caught. You gotta do this little thing over here, shimmy over there. Just don't get caught, or you have to go start all over back to your room. Not good. Yeah, it's just stay out of their way. Just match their timing. Run! Or scamper. She can't really run. She's in a dress. Okay, get out of his sight. Oh god, Twink! Get out of the sight! Let's see. I'm following you. I'm gonna follow you. Haha. Oh, we get a badge. Power Rush. Alright, we'll have to put that in a special place later. Oh, what's this? What do they gotta talk about? Maybe if I move up a little, then they could talk. Oh, there we go.
Hey, have you heard about Master Tubba Blubba? I heard a rumor that he loves eating ghosts.
Ghosts, huh? Master Tubba Blubba, he lives deep inside the Forever Forest, doesn't he? I think he's guarding one of them at the Star Spirits right now.
Yeah, Master Tubba Blubba lives in the castle at the top of Gusty Glutch. I heard that somewhere near his castle is a mansion and a village full of ghosts. I guess Master Tubba Blubba sometimes goes there to catch a boo. And then, when he catches one, he gobbles it up down, starting with its head. Chomp!
Oh man, that sounds scary! Now, I won't be able to walk to the bathroom alone at night. I'm gonna have nightmares. I don't know it. Why'd you tell me?
I also hear that the Master Tubba Blubba is invincible. They say he can't even get hurt. So nobody can even touch him. He might even be stronger than King Bowser.
Stronger than King Bowser? Come on, that's impossible. Even Master Tubba Blubba is to have some weak points. It's just common sense.
Yeah, you may be right. There's another rumor that Tubba Blubba's got a secret that would ruin him if anyone ever found out. I bet it's about this past. I heard he didn't used to be strong at all.
Sha! You know, if Master Tubba Blubba hears you, he might gobble us up. Still, what do you think his secret could be anyway?
I don't know. No one knows. That's why it's a secret, you half-wit!
Twink, it sounds like Master Tubba Blubba has the weak point after all. If only we could find out.
Hey, did you hear something talking just now?
Gasp!
Did you hear someone... You think someone knows we're goofing off in here?
Oh, whoa! Princess Peach, how'd you get in here?
I'm sorry to do this, but you have to go back to your room right now.
Oh no!
And Twink just runs away again. He's so awkward when he leaves. And finally, don't that Peach and Luigi's took half the part. But anyway, back to real life Mario.
Thank you, Mario. At last, I can return home to Star Haven. My name's Mamar. So nice to meet you in person. You still got a long way to go, but I just thought you could save Princess Peach. I'll do my best to help you. Here's a present for you.
Yay! Glitter! Yeah. Mario's star energy goes up by 2. Mario can now use the Lullaby, a new star spirit power. With Lullaby, you can now make all enemies fall asleep.
Call on me when times are bad. Believe in this, Mario. My powers are strong. I am a star spirit, after all. Our powers are growing all the time. Keep up the good work, Mario. You must save the other star spirits as soon as possible. For now, I'm going back to recover in Star Haven. Who knows how my dear old Star Haven is faring without the Star Rod. Goodbye, Mario. I'm off.
Up, up, and away! Alright, so that's 2 Star Spirits. There we go. And that's what I'm talking about. Yeah, let's heal up. Everything's light out again. Cool. Alright, let's find our way out of here. I'm done with this desert. I know in these parts I haven't shown like what you could find in each of these desert parts, but I'll make a video like later of what you can get in the stuff, so don't worry about it. That'll be later. But anyway, back to the here and now. We'll just go back to where we came from and go back to the train and head back to Toad Town. But first, I want to do something. Remember that artifact we found? Let's deliver it to an old friend that we met earlier in this chapter. So let's just switch back to Cooper. I don't know if we need him or not, but it would be appropriate. So let's talk to Colorado.
Well, what ill luck. No clues about the ruins. I'm getting so frustrated, I just might have to give up on this excavation. For now, how very sad. I say? Mario, that artifact you hold in your hand. It looks quite important. Do my eyes deceive me, or is that a clue to the dry ruins? Mario, old chum, I beg of you. Could you possibly part with it?
Yeah, I'll give you the artifact.
Here, cheers, Mario, smashing really old boy. Soon now the mysterious dry ruins will rise up from the sands that conceal them. As a brilliant archaeologist, I say it must be so. I suppose a thank you gift is in order, eh, old boy? Here you go, and he gives us a star piece. You know, old bean, it's quite a bit of magic in this desert. Cherish the memory, old boy.
Aw, man. I tried doing my British accent, but it didn't come out as well as I had anticipated. But anyway, let's save here and let's trudge on back to the train station. Yippee, this is going to be fun. Okay, that was just the beginning of my new recording. Let's see, we're good. Let's go back to the train station. I wish you didn't have to walk all the way back, because this is just a waste of 2 minutes right here. But whatever. We'll just make the trudge on forward. But we actually have to do some things that we can get to now with Harakari, so I'm going to show that off in this part, so that's why I didn't cut it out. But, you know, let's fall down there, take this up. That's why I didn't cut it out. I just would have cut it out to the train station if I didn't have to do anything. But I'll need to do some things with Harakari, so everything has a rhyme and reason and purpose, so let's just get to that purpose. This purpose that drives us, that guides us. Going on Matrix, Mr. Anderson, Tangent, or Agent Smith, for that matter. Yeah, Matrix is awesome movies. They're sick. Alright, save again. Cool beans. Let's see, what did we switch to? Paracarry? Oh god, Assassin! Let's get another bump. Yay! My friend's back. It's like a Quagsire. It's like a combination of a Quagsire and a Diglett. That's definitely it. It's a combination of a Quagsire and a Diglett. That's what it looks like. I think I just described something perfectly for the first time ever. But anyway, we got the whackers bump, so let's just, heart block unnecessary, but whatever. Let's just, switch to paracarry. Stone block, must smash, stone block, smash, Mario, smash! There we go, let's see what that uncovers in Amneos. Partner power-up, cool. Let's use that on paracarry. It's Goombario, you suck. Let's do it, paracarry. Let's bring him out, and let's glitter him with some power upgrade goodness. Sha-sha-sha-sha! Oh yeah, I didn't have to do anything with paracarry. This is the thing I remember I had to do. So that's why I showed it, so yeah. But anyway guys, I have a question for you. Should I put up the chapter then like the part like chapter 1, part 7? Or should I leave it like it is with just parts, like part 22 or 23? Your choice. I want to hear what you guys have to say. Just post in the comments below. I have a little thing set up. But anyway, next time, chapter 3. And we'll save up here. See you later guys. Until next time.